All right, the subject of this video is node voltage analysis. In previous videos, I've pointed out that a voltage is always a difference, meaning you can't just look at one part of a circuit and say, oh, the voltage is 10 volts, or the voltage is 20 volts, or the voltage is 100 volts, because just saying what a voltage is meaningless unless you have a reference for that voltage. It means that to define a voltage, you really have to have two wires, because a voltage is always a difference. You see, that's not the situation with current, because current moves through a wire and it's a measure of flow. So you can just say, along this wire, we have this amount of current flowing. You see, a current just requires one wire, but a voltage requires two points because you have to measure the voltage difference from one point to another. But in node voltage analysis, we can make it look like we only have one point for a voltage by giving it a common reference. And a convenient reference is ground in most circuits. So for example, let's say that we've got a 10 volt DC source. What that means is that we have 10 volts between the two sides of the source. However, what if I put another source in series with it? And let's say that this is a 15 volt source. 15 volts just means that we have a 15 volt difference between two different points of the circuit. But what's the voltage up here? Well, again, it doesn't make sense to just say, oh, the voltage here is some number. You might think, oh, I should write 25 volts right here. Ah, that's not exactly correct. 25 volts with respect to what? Because what if I had another voltage source down here that's labeled 20 volts? If I had labeled this node up here 25, then I would immediately have a problem. So what we do in circuit analysis in order to avoid writing differences all over the place is to define a common ground or a zero point in the circuit. So let's go ahead and do that with this sample. If I have a common ground, then I can get rid of these reference points and just say that at this node, I've got 20 volts because this is defined as zero. At this node, I've got, let's see, an extra 15, which would be 35 volts. And up here, I would have 45 volts. So in node voltage analysis, it is possible to say, okay, this point is a certain voltage because I've defined my zero point. I could redefine the zero point. I could say, okay, what if my ground is 10 volts? Then I add 10 to everything in the circuit, and all the calculations that come from the node voltage analysis would still be accurate. So let's go ahead and finish out this example circuit and put a single resistor on it. Let's say that this is a 45 ohm resistor. If I have a 45 ohm resistor and I have a problem finding the current, then the current is obviously just going to be 1 ampere because V equals IR. And the advantage of node voltage analysis is that you can very easily just write a single voltage on a circuit, and it can be less confusing than using the Kirchhoff voltage law. That being said, the two have some deep mathematical connection, and any circuit that you can solve using the Kirchhoff voltage and current laws, you can also solve it using using node voltage analysis with the Kirchhoff current laws. Let's now solve the same circuit that we solved using the Kirchhoff voltage law using node voltage analysis. The node that I have labeled here, it's the same as this node, it's the same as this node. Sometimes in circuits we might label multiple nodes, but you know, because they're all connected with a wire, mathematically they're all the same point. Let's now use the node voltage analysis and let's label this V. V with respect to what, right? So we need to give it a common ground. So let's define this as 0 volts. And this is my definition. And any place on the circuit will work. You can define any node as your ground point. As long as you use that ground point consistently in your circuit, then all the voltages you label on your circuit diagram will be referenced to that same point. And all of the currents and voltages that you calculate it will then be consistent with that point. All right, so it now makes sense for me to just say, what is V, what is I1, and what is I2? So rather than use the Kirchhoff voltage law, where we have loops, let's just use node voltage analysis. Usually with node voltage analysis, it involves using Ohm's law and writing voltages at nodes. So the voltage at this node is just 10 volts because we're defined as zero and we've got a voltage source. This voltage is the same as this one right here. So in fact, now all the nodes are defined. How many nodes do we have in the circuit? Well, we have the ground node. That's here, here, and here. That's one node. It's the same node. They're all connected with wire. We have a node here in between these two circuit elements, and I've labeled it 10 volts. And I have a node over here, and I don't know the voltage on it, so I've labeled it V, an unknown parameter. So three nodes, two of them are known, one of them is not. I have two currents, and I don't know what they are. Right, so let's use Ohm's law for this resistor, and then we'll apply Ohm's law to this resistor. All right, well, Ohm's law is V equals IR, where V means voltage difference. So let's use the direction of the arrow so we don't have to worry about negative numbers. So as the arrow flies, 10 minus V equals I times R. All right, now let's do the same thing over here. As the arrow flies, we start with V on this side of the arrow and zero on this side of the arrow. V minus zero equals IR. And that's my node voltage analysis. I have two equations, but I have three unknowns. So I still need to use the Kirchhoff current law in order to get my third equation. So current in to my voltage node is I1 and current out is 2 plus I2. So I now have three different equations, and the answers for current I1 and I2 will be the same as they were with the Kirchhoff voltage law that we applied in the previous problem. If you enjoyed watching this video, then you might be interested in following our playlist and learning more about the fundamentals of electrical circuits.